While I was preaching in a church in South Africa, an American lady whose son resided in the state of Iowa was present in a weeknight service. Before the service began, she called me into the vestry and said she had just received a letter from her daughter-in-law. It stated that the woman's son, a college professor, appeared to be tubercular. He was compelled to give up his teaching position and was in a condition of great weakness. As I conversed with the mother, I observed that she, too, believed her son to be tubercular and that, unless healing came to him quickly, he would die. I returned to the audience room, and as we were about to pray, I stepped to the end of the platform and asked the mother to hand me the letter. Taking it in my hands, I knelt to pray, inviting all present to join me in faith in God for the man's deliverance. My spirit seemed to ascend in God, and I lost all consciousness of my environment. Suddenly, I found myself standing in that young man's home in Iowa, nearly 10,000 miles from Johannesburg. The man sat by a hard coal heater with a little boy about 2 years old on his lap. I observed him critically and said to myself, "Your face is hard and shows no evidence of soul development or spiritual life, yet your affection for your son is a redeeming quality." His wife sat on the opposite side of the table, reading a magazine. Observing her, I remarked to myself, "When he got you, he got a Tartar." While standing behind the man's chair, I laid my hands on his head, silently praying for God to impart to him his healing virtue and make the man well, that he might bless the world and that his mother's heart might be comforted. There was no knowledge of my return. In a moment, I was aware that I was kneeling on the church platform. I had been uttering audible prayer and the Spirit of God was resting deeply upon the people. Some 6 weeks later, word was received that the young man was quite well. His recovery had begun on the exact date that prayer was offered for him in our church 10,000 miles away.